I see you, champion. Sit, please.
If you walk by, you'll miss out on a good trade.
Sit with me, Outlander. I've got something to tell
you. Are you looking to buy?
Looking up for that. Sound like it is. Maybe if I follow their tracks, I can find out where they're headed. I can probably use my focus to follow the tracks and riders.
That girl was wound up tighter than a twisted spring. She didn't have to hit me.
Well, she didn't like you going through the parcels. She warned you twice.
I was just... curious is all. There's a lot of odds here.
Well, thanks to you, she bolted like a hare on fire.
Break from this heat. That doesn't look good. I should check it out. Stock for later. Looks like the Osram used some kind of harpoon to take this machine down. I must have attacked the camp. Maybe my focus can help me figure out why. These are tall neck antennas. The Osram must have stripped them somehow. Osram were killed by machines. So the one they took down wasn't alone. A harpoon weapon. With anchors? Were they? They were trying to take down that tall neck. So the Osram wanted to weigh down that tall neck and strip it for parts. The machines must have caught them in the act. I wish there was a way to climb up and inspect the damage. Unless I take down the tall neck myself and try to repair it on the ground. It won't be pretty, but at least it'll get fixed. Must have set up all the systems in the area. I just gotta find them. There's probably other anchors set up in the area. I need to find them. Use them to tip down Atomic. That ballista. I should look for others in the area. Looks like machines got to this one too. Another ballista. And it's got one of the anchors I need. I'll have to hook an anchor to the weak spots in its armor to weigh it down. One more should weigh it down enough. Machines, I need to hurry.
Thank you.
better. That weapon still has an anchor. Let's use it. You, I can figure out what needs fixing.
Thank you.
can do something with this. Nothing but trouble. I should lie low. Find whoever's in charge and take them out. Maybe then the rest will leave. This must be the ruins of Las Vegas. Poseidon shouldn't be far. Gaia said this is where I'd find Poseidon, but the ruins out here are exposed to the elements. A lot of them are buried in the sand. So maybe Poseidon is underground. If that's true, I might be able to find a way down through one of these structures. some kind of drone. Is it watching over this area? Might have some useful data. But how to get up there? Water's pouring out of that building. Poseidon's doing? I better check it out. Someone's been through here.
I was at him. I was so close.
To drowning, maybe. Not to the embers. Moreland, it's over.
Well, not for me, it's not.
Then you're going to die. Alone, because we're not sticking around to fish out the corpse. We're through.
And so the visionary's fate hung in the balance. Would he choose life or succumb to deadly delusion?
Hello. So, there's an ancient city under the sand. But it's flooded.
Suddenly, a Nora Spear Maiden appeared.
Yeah, okay. Well, you're not typical Delvers. That's for sure. What's this?
I call it a diving bubble. This is the Mark One. The Mark Two was better, but it got stuck halfway down. Air tube snagged.
You went down in that.
Yeah, I hardly expect a layperson to understand.
Because that's pretty smart.
I'm sorry. May I remind you, you got stuck inside and nearly drowned.
It'd have to be portable, though. Machine kneecap, maybe?
Well, you'd need a filter.
Synthetic membrane would do it. With a hose to a
compressed air capsule. Hammer and tongs.
What is this? What is happening here? What? Get over here. She's a stranger.
You got a name?
Aloy.
Moreland. Not a stranger anymore.
You're a damn fool.
Come on. I got the original schematics over here.
Well, hold on. Just a couple of questions first.
Fair enough. Partner?
Partner?
Don't mind. find him.
What's so important down there that you'd risk your life?
Well...
Moreland, I'm not interested in salvage, okay? Whatever you find below is yours.
Well, all right. Then what if I told you we were delving for the most spectacular treasures ever scribed by man or maid?
I'd say get to the point.
No nonsense. I like it. Behold, an ember.
Looks like a piece of junk.
Well, now, yes, but with a proper spark, these magnificent creations of the old ones paint mesmerizing pictures in the air, and the ruins below us are full of them. A feast for the eyes beyond description. This is my old Gramps promised me.
So these embers project images?
Paintings of light. It's amazing stuff. This one showed the most beautiful woman you've ever seen, beckoning all to a buffet of lobster and succulent beefs. I must have watched it about 100 times as a child in my old Gramps workshop.
What happened to it?
Over time, they die out. I cried the day that this one's light faltered. But there are many more below, as you'll see if you get down there like I did and my old Gramps before me.
How did your grandfather discover these embers?
He was here. 40-odd years ago, he was one of the first to lead a delving party into the West. He discovered the ancient city around us, plumbed the depths of this very structure. He found the hollow underneath and the glowing embers all about. Took as many as he could and brought them home. He always wanted to come back and get more, but, well, never scraped up the shards. What he really wanted to do was use the embers to put on a show. One unlike the world has ever seen.
Sounds like quite a guy.
He was a true delver. And a true showman. And I miss him. But I will do him proud. I will gather the embers and put on a spectacle that would have amazed even him. With your help, of course.
So what exactly happened down there?
It was a delve like no other. A chance to follow my old Gramps footsteps. Beneath this structure here is an enormous hollow, a dome protected from the sands. We built this elevator here to ensure easy egress and exit. It's quite a contraption, actually, and not so easy that...
Right. Again. What happened?
At the bottom, we beheld the treasure my Gramps first discovered. Painted images in the air of every description. Dancing women, games, and coins, and promises of jackpots. I don't know what that is, but it's gotta be good. Then, something went wrong. The images turned nautical. Waves went through them, even fish. It's like a strange underwater dream.
Poseidon's dream.
Yes. Well, suddenly there was this terrible rushing sound, and then an explosion of water erupted from the floor.
So water just shot up from the floor and filled the place up?
It was a raging flood unlike anything I've seen. We ran like forge fire and barely made it up the elevator as a wave just crashed beneath us. Shaken, but not stirred, I built the diving bubbles Mark 1 and Mark 2. I tried the descent in each, but I nearly drowned both times. Abbott Dunn's beside himself. He thinks I'm insane. But I can't give up now.
I've come too far. And the embers are just barely within my reach.
Well, maybe I can help.
Yeah. Maybe you can.
You guys don't seem like average Delvers.
We're not really Delvers at all. We're showmen.
Like performers?
You're Nora, and thus unfamiliar with the arts. We stage spectacles all around the claim. Stemmer tells stories, which I augment with all manner of sounds and fireworks, and Abaddon, he, well...
complains?
He handles the money, which amounts to about the same thing. When we delve, it's to find gear for my theatrics. Which makes this delve the most important one of all.
How deep is it? Can't I just swim down?
Only if you have gills. You can stack 50 kegs in that shaft.
Leave it to the Oseram to measure something in kegs.
Talking liquid depths. I'd say it's apt.
Apt or not, sounds too deep to hold my breath.
Hence, our new invention.
I'd better get after those parts.
There's a fully intact compressed air capsule in the Mark II, but like I said, it's stuck in the shaft.
If you made it back up alive, I should be able to swim down that far.
All right. As for the other parts, Stemmer scouted a herd due south of here that should have what we need.
I'm on it.
Great.
Got the compressed air capsule. Now, to get all the machine parts. According to Moreland, the herd should be south of here. Well, this is where Moreland said the herd would be. They must have moved on. I need to pick up their trail. Better look for tracks. I'll keep some extra on hand. Maybe my focus can help here. There. Tracks should lead me to the herd. Sandstorm's blowing in. Just what I need. There's the herd. I should have the parts I need. More machines? I better deal with them first. Whipped up a sand spiral. Great. Okay, got them all. Now, where did the herd go? The sandstorm's giving its all. It looks like the herd's caught between those sandstorms. Maybe it's in the village. One synthetic memory. I should have all the parts to build this thing now. Get back to work.
What can I do for you, partner?
I've got everything I need to build the,
the incredible diving mask.
I think diving mask is enough.
I won't quibble. The workbench is all yours. A marvel. If it works, you'll let me try it? I want to get down there and get those embers.
Assuming I don't drown.
So what are you really looking for down there?
It's hard to explain. Something that caused a malfunction in the apparatus that controls the old city. I think it started the flood.
Well, I thought we started the flood. Like we sprung a trap. I don't know how we were detected. Like I said, the dancing lights around us changed, turned to sea life. There was this flash of red, and the roar of water surging in.
Wait, a flash of red?
A red light from a spot near the grate on the floor where the water burst through. It was like a beacon.
Or a warning. Thanks. That might help.
I hope it does. And good luck down there.
Okay, time to see if this thing works. So far, so good. I can actually breathe down here. Mask seems to be holding up. I've never been able to swim this deep before.
It started right here, more than 30 years ago. Back when this casino was still called the Temple. One big bet turned my fate around. But now, fate's dealt its cruelest hand ever to everyone. I have to turn the lights out one final time. And the waters of my adopted home will at last run dry. Well, if a dream has to die, at least, I can say goodbye first.
Stanley Chen. What did he do here? nautical lights. It must be Poseidon's doing. Looks like a way out. Poseidon's down here, somewhere. Gotta find where it's hiding. Whoa! All of it's encased in a dome.
Detected. Automatic drainage controls offline. To execute an emergency purge, manual reset of primary and secondary pump nodes is required. The purge can then be triggered at the pump maintenance station.
If I do this purge and drain all the water, I can fight that big machine on dry ground. Looks like I have to reset a couple of pump nodes first. According to the map, there should be an access point for the first node south of here. Machines down here. I'll swim around them. Stick to cover. There's the access point. Should lead me to the pump node. Must be a whole network of these tunnels down here. Water lines for an entire city. Something I can climb to get out. Well, it's warm. It's almost relaxing. Thank you. one node down. Better swim back up and find the access point for the second node. According to the map, the second node should be on the other side of the dome. Another access point. Should get me to the second node. Taken care of both nodes. Now I just need to activate the emergency purge at the maintenance station.
Just shut down the secondary node.
The domes, the water. He was responsible for all of it. According to the map, the maintenance stations should be at the south end of the dome.
Better move it.
We have light in our tower. Just look at the console I found earlier. That might be the maintenance station. But how to get in? Let's see where this leads. I think I'm in the maintenance station now. I just gotta find a console to activate the emergency purge. There should be a console in here. There. Time to dry this place out.
Did it!
Okay. Now I can deal with that machine guarding the door on the other end. And once I get past it, I can get to what's waiting on the other side of the door. Excitement. At least the purge didn't get rid of all of the water. Ready for anything now? Okay. Poseidon is through there. But where did that machine go?
Aloy! It's a miracle!
Is this you? Did you lower the waters?
Yeah, but there's a new problem. That thing's in our way.
Wow. Yeah, it's gonna be difficult to get the embers with that around.
As the scrappy band of adventurers beheld the beast, they knew what they had to do.
What? Are you crazy?
Hush now. She saved our Delph.
Okay, then. Stay up here, and start firing when I engage.
Overhang.
need this.
Thank you.
won this fight.
Thank you.
to my stash. Poseidon should be somewhere beyond this door. I will bring it home. Poseidon should be hiding in some kind of processor. I need to find a console to gain access to it. There. I should be able to use that console.
I can't do it. I can't give up on this place. I'm leaving everything on standby. The system's equipped for runs for decades, if not hundreds of years. It's a long shot. But maybe someday, against all odds, someone will find this place again, marvel at its lights and wonders, discover a fortune and boundless opportunity, make it their own dream. After all, if the city can give me a second chance, if water can flow in the wasteland, anything's possible.
He was right. I'm here to bring you home, Poseidon. To Gaia.
Yes, Mother.
Elizabeth Sobek, Alpha Prime.
Master override activated. Restoring Poseidon's subordinate function to original code.
Gotta bring this back to Gaia.
System reboot initiated.
Looks like taking Poseidon triggered a restart of the city's power system. Roland and crew must have headed back up top. All the numbers they could carry, I bet.
Thank you.
It started right here, more than 30 years ago. Back when this casino was still called the Temple.
Yeah, you must have built this before the place flooded.
One big bet turned my fate around.
Nice not to have to climb back up.
Fate's dealt its cruelest hand ever.
An elevator.
To everyone.
You
I have to turn the lights out one final time.
It has to work.
And the waters of my adopted home were the last one dry. Well, if a dream has to die, at least I can say goodbye first.
Another recording from Stanley Chen.
Whatever she did,
show my old gramps always wanted.
There's another.
His dream realized. His old gramps' legacy ensured. Our hero beheld the sea of desert lights and wept at his good fortune.
When I saw the embers as a child, I never dreamed they could be like this. Thank you, Aloy. Did you find what you were looking for?
I did. And now I have to move on.
Oh. Come back when you can. I got big plans for this place.
I thought you wanted to put on shows with the embers back in the claim.
Oh, no. This is the show. Oh, can you imagine? Folks from all over the land coming to take it all in. Plus, some food and a nice place to stay.
Not to mention a variety of entertainment venues.
Don't forget, games of chance. Plenty of shards to be had there for certain.
A new dream, huh? I hope you make it happen. Goodbye, gentlemen.
This delve is a story for the ages. All thanks to you.
If Moreland and crew's gonna stay, maybe I should come back and check on them later. For now, I need to get Poseidon back to Gaia. But I might want to pay a visit to that other Ostrom camp I found first. And with my new diving mask, I should be able to swim as deep as I want to.
I see you, champion. Sit, please.
You shouldn't miss this chance to trade.
Welcome back, Aloy. I see you have recovered Poseidon.
Aloy, can you come downstairs? Beta has something you need to hear.
Okay. I'll be right down.
Aloy, I have managed to unlock additional rooms within the facility.
Got it.
Now this file's crazy. Why would anyone use oil to do that?
Hi! Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
She found that recording from the data on your focus. She's been watching it a lot. I think it helps calm her.
You know, I used to watch this a lot too. Whenever I wanted to take my mind off things.
Daddy sure does love his little bit.
But there's something you need to tell me?
While you were gone, I came down here to check on her. Then we started talking. Right, Beta? She's been thinking about how to capture Hephaestus, studying the data Gaia gave her. But we started talking about some other stuff. You know, just getting to know each other, right? And then she told me that one of the Zeniths might be different from the others.
Tilda. You saw her at the Hades Proving Lab.
Go on.
On the way to Earth, the Zeniths never showed their faces. My servitor caretaker referred to them as my benefactors, and promised I'd meet them someday, when I had learned enough. And then, one day, a data channel opened in my training interface. In it, Tilda was waiting for me, in a virtual replica of a house on a cliff, overlooking the ocean. It was beautiful. She showed me paintings, books, media files. We met there in secret many times. But a few months later, it stopped.
Can you tell us why, Beta?
I found some data about Tilda at the Hades Proving Lab. I think she was a liaison between Far Zenith and Zero Dawn. She knew Elizabeth Sobeck, that's for sure.
Maybe that's why she reached out to you?
What else can you tell us about Tilda? She liked to talk about her paintings. What about herself? Did she ever talk about her life on Earth, how she joined the Zeniths, something like that? She never said much about herself, and she hated it when I asked too many questions. But I think, back on Earth, she was an expert programmer, given that she built a data channel the other Zeniths couldn't detect. Is there anything else about her that we might be able to use to our advantage? She was the first real person who ever bothered to speak to me. I wasn't really assessing her for strengths and weaknesses. You said that Tilda reached out to you using a data channel? It appeared in my training interface as another assignment. When I opened it, there were a series of intermittent glitches. I realized they formed a transpositional cipher. Instructions on how to open up a new virtual space. When I entered it, my training interface disappeared. Instead of the usual holographic teachers and files, I was in a perfect recreation of her home. And you're sure the other Zeniths never knew about it? To them, it looked like I was still in training. Toiling away. Alone. So this secret virtual space looked like a house with an ocean view? I could see whitecaps and hear waves crashing on rocks below. And there were gulls, crying outside. Inside, Tilda had frames that showed off her favorite paintings, changing at intervals to match the light. There was an armchair she liked. She'd sit there and gaze outside while I looked through her things. We spent hours in that house. I never wanted to leave. You said Tilda showed you paintings and let you access media files? Every time we met, she showed me a new painting. I think she was Dutch. All of her favorite pieces were from their golden age in the 1600s. Portraits, allegories, ships at sea. She had so many.
They didn't interest you?
I liked her media portal. It had so much more than my training interface. Clips, shows, holos. My favorite was this one called Second Time Around, about a family whose kid comes back after disappearing during the Hot Zone crisis.
Right, but did this portal have anything about the Zeniths themselves? Anything we could use?
No. Any information about them was redacted.
So Tilda set up a secret virtual space where she could talk to you, a house on a cliff. Then later, she cut you off. But other than the fact that Tilda knew Elizabeth, you don't know why she did those things?
I don't, okay? I thought of every possible reason that would make her leave, but whatever I did wrong, I don't know what it is.
When I finally met the others, she ignored me. Acted like the data channel never existed. None of this even matters. Tilda's the same as the others. It won't help us defeat them.
Okay. Let's leave it at that, then.
What's wrong?
I'm trying, Varl. But she is tough to take. I'm out there in the wilds, risking my life every day, and all she can do is hide in there and tell us how hopeless it all is. I'm sorry, she's had a rough time, but she is really not helping right now.
Hmm. You always seem to be on top of everything, so I sometimes forget about what you've been through. I mean, it wasn't that long ago you were so banged up you couldn't even walk. About that. When I pulled you out of the water back near the Proving Lab, you were muttering Rost's name. You never talk about him. But he raised you. Trained you. You must miss him a lot.
Of course I do. But I don't have time to think about that now. I need to get back out there.
Okay. I'll keep working with Beta. Gaia says she knows a lot about Zero Dawn. And maybe she just needs some time to adjust, and then she can help us with Hephaestus.
Sure. But I won't hold my breath.
One of my machine strike pieces around?
Why don't you check the cache? Maybe you left it there when you dropped off.
Oh.
It's snowing soon.
Outlander, I've got something.